Good evening, welcome to North West Shots. You're watching North West Shots Daily Evening Bulletin. This is Angel. Let's start with national news. Prime Minister Modi launched PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan for Multimodal Connectivity today at 11 a.m. at Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. Gati Shakti is a national infrastructure master plan which will lay the foundation of holistic infrastructure and will lead to an integrated and holistic pathway to our economy. Prime Minister Modi addressed 28th National Human Rights Commission NHRC Foundation Day program. Said India is committed to human rights. When the poorest of the poor do not get an equal share of the government schemes, then the question of rights arises. Judges elevated as Chief Justices of various High Courts. Justice Mohammad Rafiq, Himachal Pradesh High Court, has its new Chief Justice. Justice Rajesh Bindal, Chief Justice of the Allahabad High Court. Justice Ranjit V. Morey of Meghalaya was made Chief Justice. Justice Satish Chandra Sharma has been elevated as Chief Justice of the Telangana High Court. Justice Prakash Srivastava has been made Chief Justice of the Calcutta High Court. Justice R. V. Malimath will now head the Madhya Pradesh High Court. Justice Ritu Raj will head the Karnataka High Court. Justice Arvind Kumar, Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court. Justice Prashant Kumar Mishra has been made Chief Justice of the Andhra Pradesh High Court. Justice Indrajit Mahanti has been posted as Chief Justice of the Tripura High Court. Justice Biswanath Somadhar has been posted as Chief Justice of the Sikkim High Court. Justice A.A. Qureshi as Chief Justice of the Rajasthan High Court. Justice A.K. Goswami will head the Chhattisgarh High Court. Former Secretary HRD Information and Broadcasting Amit Khare, an IAS officer of the 1985 batch, was on Tuesday appointed as the advisor to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Khare retired as the secretary on 30th of September. Billionaire Rakesh Jhunjhunwala promoted Akasha Air have received no objection certificate from the Aviation Ministry and plans to start operations by middle of 2022. The Power Ministry on 12th October asked states to utilize unallocated power of the Central Generating Stations CGS to meet the requirement of their own consumers amid the ongoing coal shortage crisis in the country. Airlines can operate domestic flights without any capacity restrictions from October 18th. The carriers have been operating 85% of their pre-COVID domestic services since 18 September 2021, government stated. PhD not mandatory for recruitment as assistant professor till July 2023. UGC extends date of applicability of PhD as mandatory qualification for direct recruitment of assistant professor in departments of universities from July 1, 2021 to July 1, 2023. Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy inaugurated the Sri Padmavati Pediatric Cardiac Hospital, the first of its kind exclusive children's heart hospital in the state. Jammu and Kashmir, in major anti-militancy operations in Jammu and Kashmir launched following selective killings, security forces have eliminated 7 militants since Monday night. Karnataka, the Cauvery Water Regulation Committee urged Karnataka to release Tamil Nadu's due of 25.84 TMC feet of Cauvery water, besides making available the mandatory 14 TMC feet water at Billingundu before October 30th this year. An earthquake measuring 3.5 magnitude on Richter scale shook parts of Kalaburagi district on Tuesday morning, but no loss of life or damage to property has been reported. This is the sixth earthquake to hit North Karnataka region around Bidar and Kalaburagi since October 1. While two had occurred in Basava Kalyan on October 1 and 5, four were recorded in Kalaburagi on October 9, 11 and 12. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan on Tuesday said instructions would be given to complete the government's level procedures at the earliest to withdraw police cases registered during the Sabarimala and NTCAA protests in the state. The Kerala government indicated that the centre's plan to privatise Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited would not adversely impact the interests of its ambitious petrochemical park being set up in Kochi. The National Investigation Agency on 12th of October conducted raids at 20 locations across Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu in the Idakara case pertaining to a conspiracy by CPI Maoist members. Maharashtra, Mumbai's Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj International Airport is set to reopen its Terminal 1 for domestic flights from October 13th. Punjab Congress Chief Navjot Singh Sidhu is scheduled to meet All India Congress Committee General Secretary Organization on 14th of October, Thursday, to discuss organizational matters related to Punjab. Telangana, while the Election Commission has previously removed the auto rickshaw, truck, hat and iron box from the list of free symbols for independence and unrecognized registered parties following requests from TRS, the party is now seeking freezing of some more symbols that resemble its car symbol. Bollywood Big B Amitabh Bachchan has terminated his contract with the Pan Masala brand, saying that he wasn't aware that the promotion falls under surrogate advertising. The decision comes after a national anti-tobacco organization requested him to withdraw from the ad campaign, claiming that it would prevent youngsters from getting addicted to tobacco. Coming towards the defense news, Indian Army Chief General Manoj Mukund Navarane arrived in Sri Lanka on Tuesday. He was welcomed by General Savindra Silva, Chief of Defense Staff and Commander of Sri Lanka Army, at the airport. He is on a 5-day goodwill visit. Senior BSF officer D.K. Bora, who has served in the Special Protection Group, SPG, that protects the country's Prime Minister, 11th of October, took over as the Inspector General of the Forces Jammu Frontier. Coming towards the international news, Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar is holding a series of meetings this week in Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan and Armenia, India's key partners in Central Asia and Eurasia. During the first leg of his visit, Jaishankar on 11th of October held extensive dialogues with Kyrgyz Foreign Minister Ruslan Kazakbayev in Bishkek on the Afghanistan situation. G20 leaders agreed to work together to avoid a humanitarian disaster in Afghanistan as the EU pledged a 1 billion euro aid package, and host Italy stressed the need to maintain contracts with the Taliban. As the Islamist group led its first face-to-face talks with a US-EU delegation in Qatar, US President Joe Biden, Turkey's Recep Tayyip Erdogan and India's PM Modi joined a virtual summit on the looming economic and humanitarian crisis sparked by the Taliban's return to power. Coming towards the world news, the United Nations Security Council strongly condemned the atrocious ISIS terror attack on a mosque in Afghanistan and other recent attacks against religious institutions. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un reviewed a rare exhibition of weapons systems and vowed to build an invincible military, as he accused the United States of creating tensions and not taking action to prove it has no hostile intent toward the North. The Dutch Crown Princess can marry whoever she wants without giving up her right to the throne, Prime Minister Mark Rutte said. He also said princess can marry a person of whatever gender she chooses without forfeiting her right to the throne. Crown Princess Katharina Amalia, 17, has not made any comments on the matter. The question arose after a recently published book argued that the country's rules exclude the possibility of a same-sex royal couple. Unlike regular marriages, royal marriages need the approval of parliament. Members of the Dutch royal house have on occasion given up their place in the line of succession to marry someone without permission. Gay marriage was legalized in the Netherlands in 2001. At least 28 people were killed and more than a dozen injured on 12 October after a packed passenger bus plunged off a road in a hilly region in northeastern Nepal. More than 130 Yamini rebels have been killed in strikes south of Marib since fighting for Marib flared last month. Marib City is the internationally recognized government's last bastion in oil-rich northern Yemen. Hundreds of Iran-backed Houthi rebels and government loyalists have died. According to military sources, the rebels seized Al-Jouba district in southern Marib province. Coming towards the sports news, SAFF Championship. The Indian football team registered their first win of the tournament over Nepal. Sunil Chhetri once again proved savior as he rescued the Indian team, helping it record a 1-0 win over Nepal. In the last two games, India were held for a draw by Bangladesh and Sri Lanka. Coming towards the end, COVID update national. India reported 15,823 new COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours, 10.5% higher than yesterday when the country saw the lowest daily rise in COVID cases since early March, with 14,313 infections. India also reported 226 deaths due to coronavirus. The active COVID-19 case in India comprised 0.61% of the total infections, the lowest since March 2020. The active caseload at present is 2,07,653, lowest in 214 days. India's total COVID infection tally has reached 3,40,01,743, while the death count has increased to 4,51,189. A total of 13,25,399 tests were conducted, taking the number of cumulative tests conducted so far to 58,63,63,442. With this, we come to an end of today's news headlines. Thank you so much for tuning in. We're also available in Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. This is Angel Rai signing off for now. Good night.